Hello everyone, welcome back to computer class. Today I am going to continue the remaining part from unit 1 from chapter number 4, that is data types in Java. First, content, rules for naming a variable, limitations to a variable name, assignment and operators. Last one, data types in Java. First is about rules for naming a variable. We need to follow some of the rules while giving a name to any variable. First one, a variable may have any number of characters. Don't think that variable should be a single letter or a two letter, a small word like that. It should be, you can give any number of characters to a variable. It may contain alphabets, digits and underscore. Means combination of alphabet, digit, underscore you can give, but it should begin with the alphabet only. The underscore can be applied in between the characters to increase the length of a variable name. Okay, in between a two character you can give a underscore. For example, A underscore B. If you are giving A underscore B, means the computer will take it as a AB only, but length of a variable it will be increased. Variable name should be meaningful to easily depict the logic. Means give a meaningful name to your variable. For you only it will be helpful for you to depict the logic. For the further program also it will be helpful for you. Next is limitations to a variable. While giving a name to a variable, some of the limitations were there. What is that first one? A variable name should not start with a digit or a special character. Before only I have said, right? Variable name should start with the character, not with a digit or with a special character. See here, percentage VB, it is wrong. You can start a variable with character, then you can use any number of special character, digit, that is your wish, but beginning should be a any character. Second one, a variable name should not include a space in between the character. Okay, if you want to give a space between the characters, means you can use underscore, right? Don't give a normal space between a character. See here, B space double N, it won't consider it as a variable. Okay, it will consider B as a variable and N as a variable. So if you want to give a space between a variable, means you can use the underscore between that B and N. Next is token. In that token, third one, assignment. What is the meaning of token? First, token is nothing but individual element in a program. What you are using, individual element, we will call it as a token. Last two types tokens, inner tokens, two types I have explained before only. This is the third type of token, that is assignment. Assignment means the assignment sign equal is used to assign or to store the value to a variable. It's like you have learned this. If you want to store a value to a variable, means we will use a equal sign between the variable and a value, right? That we will call it as a assignment sign. Look at here. Example, int m equals to 34. M is a integer type of variable and 34 is the value if you are giving to a variable m. Means the number 34 is assigned to a variable m. Next is operators. Operator is a fourth type of token in Java. What is the meaning of operator? Operators are the symbols used to perform arithmetic or logical operations in Java. Here, operators are nothing but symbols. When you will use these kind of symbols, either while performing arithmetic or logical operation. Arithmetic means you know already what is that arithmetic: addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, right? Next is about logical operation. Logical operation you have learned three type of logical operation, and or not. For example, some of the operators are asterisk symbol, minus, plus, percentage. The symbols are called as operators in Java. Next is about data types in Java. While performing a Java program, you will give a value to a variable. It's right. If you are giving a value to a variable means that value we will call it as a data. If the data is in a number form, means we need to use either a numeric types of data, either integer, float, like that, right? So to perform those kind of operations and all, we need a data type, right? For example, m equals to 3 or 4 you are giving. That is real number, 3 or 4, right? So for that, which type of data type you will use? Either we will use, normally we will use int, right? So for that int and all, we will call it as a data type. While performing these kind of operations and all, necessarily we need to use the data types to perform the Java program. Okay, in Java, there are two types of data types. Mainly there are two types. First one, primitive data type. Second one is non-primitive data type. Primitive data types are nothing but fundamental or basic data types. These data types are built in nature, means already predefined data types in a computer. Okay, in primitive data types there are two types. First one is numeric type, second one is non-numeric type. You know that what is the meaning of numeric and what is the meaning of non-numeric. First I'll explain about numeric type. Numeric type is nothing but number. Okay, numeric is nothing but number, right? Numeric type will deal with only with a number, either an integer or a floating number. Integer means it will be a real number. Floating number means it is the number will be in the form of a fractional points, right? In the integer, there are three types of data type. First one short, second one int, third one long. Short will store 2 bytes of space in a computer memory. 2 bytes is nothing but 1 byte is equal to 8 bits, right? Short will store 2 byte, int will store 4 byte of memory, long will store 8 byte of memory. If you are using m equals to 2 is a small number, right? It is in a form of only one digit, right? So you can use a short. If the number is in a form of long number, m equals to 34,000, like that, if you are using it, you can use a long. Okay, second type of numeric type of data type is floating number. Floating number means fractional number, means m equals to 34.5, like that. Okay, in a floating number there are two type of data types in Java. First one is float, second one is double. Float will store 4 byte of memory and double will store 8 byte of memory in a computer. Okay, data types, in the data types in Java there are two types of data types, primitive data type and non-primitive data type. In a primitive data type there are two types, numeric and non-numeric. In a numeric, integer and a floating number. Next is, in a primitive data type, what is the second type? Second type is non-numeric data type, right? Non-numeric means what? It won't be in the form of number, either in a form of character, whatever, right? In that, first one is characters. In the character, it is the character will deal with the two type of data type, a character and string. Okay, character means we will use a char, it will store 2 byte of space, and string will store 2 byte of space. You already have learnt this. Char means it is used to store a one character in a single quote, right? String is used to store either a sentence or a word, right? Either a sentence or a word or a paragraph if you are going to store, means you can use a string, right? In a non-numeric data type, first one is a character, second one is boolean. Boolean is a variable, it will contain either a true or false. Okay, boolean is, using a boolean, the variable will store either a true or false, means like this. Boolean flag equals to true, boolean flag equals to false, like this. True or false condition is going on, means you can use this kind of variables and this kind of data type you can use. Okay, in Java, mainly there are two types of data types. First one, primitive data types and non-primitive data type. In a primitive data type, there are two types, numeric data type and non-numeric data type. In the numeric data type, integer and a floating point number. In a non-numeric data type, character and a boolean. In the integer, it will take only a real number. In a floating point number, it will take a fractional number. Character will take either a single letter or a whole sentence, whatever. And boolean will take a true or false condition. Okay. Second type of data type in Java is non-primitive type. Non-primitive data type is nothing but derived data types or reference data types. These data types are used, these variables or data types are used to store the memory address. Okay, these data types are used to store the memory address of an object. And the variable used for storing a memory address are called as a reference variable. And what data type you are using with that reference variable, for that data type is known as a reference data type. For example, classes, arrays, interfaces. You will get to notice the meaning of this and all. Okay. What is the non-primitive type? Non-primitive data type is nothing but derived data type or reference data type. These data types are used to store the address of a variable. Okay, if v, what is that variable? V equals to m. If you are giving v equals to 5, okay, the variable v is storing the value 5, means where that v will store, what is the address of that v, that address will be stored using a non-primitive data type. Okay, and what variable if you are using with a non-primitive data type are called as a reference variable, and what data type if you are using with that variable is known as a reference data type. For example, classes, arrays and interfaces. Thank you everyone. Have a nice day.